Hello friends, I am Joita. Hope all are doing well. Today I am going to teach you introduction on mental health nursing. In introduction on mental health nursing, what we will see? First, we will see the definition of mental health. Next, what are the components of mental health? Next, we will see indications, and at last we will see the characteristics about mentally healthy person. So, coming to the definition of mental health. Mental health is a state of emotional, psychological, and social wellness evidenced by satisfying interpersonal relationships, effective behavior, and coping, positive self-concept, and emotional stability, according to WHO, World Health Organization. So, according to World Health Organization, definition of mental health is a state of emotional, psychological, and social wellness evidenced by satisfying interpersonal relationships, effective behavior, and coping, positive self-concept, and emotional stability. Next, coming to the components. What are the components of mental health? Here mainly three components they have given. First one is the ability to accept self. So, the ability to accept self means the mentally healthy individuals feel comfortable about themselves. They feel reasonably secure and adequately accept their shortcomings. In other words, they have the self-respect. So, ability to accept self means, in other words, they have their self-respect. So, this is the ability to accept self. Next, second point is the capacity to feel right towards others. Means the individual who have the good mental health, they are able to be sincerely interested in others' welfare. Means they are able to understand what are the good for others. So this is the capacity to feel right towards others. Next, coming to the third point, the ability to fulfill life's task. Means mentally healthy person is always able to think about himself or herself, and they have their reasonable goals towards their life, and they are able to take their own decision. So this is the ability to fulfill life task. Next, coming to the indicators. Before going to point, first we need to know what is indication or indicators. Indicators means the sign. How can we understand the person is mentally healthy? This is the indicators. The indicators are given by Jahoda, 1958, at the year of 1958. The Jahoda have given all indication. Here mainly six indication he have given. So coming to the first point. First one is a positive attitude towards self. Means here this including that an objective view of self and knowledge and acceptance of strength and limitation. Means the person who have good mental health, they have knowledge and acceptance of strength and limitation, and the individual feels a strong sense of personal identity and security within the environment or society. So this is the positive attitude towards self. Next, second point is growth and development and ability for the self-actualization. So these indicators correlate with whether the individual successfully achieve the task associated with each level of development. Means the mentally healthy person successfully achieve the task by associating all level of development. So this is the growth and development and ability for self-actualization. Next, coming to the third point, that is integration. So integration include the ability to adaptively respond to the environment and the development of a philosophy of life, both of which help the individual maintain the anxiety at a manageable level in response to stressful situation. So this is the integration. Next, what is the fourth point? That is autonomy. Autonomy refers to individual's ability to perform in an independent, self-directed manner, and individual make their own choice and accept responsibility for the outcome. So, autonomy means mentally healthy individual and makes their own choice and accept and the responsibility of their outcomes. In other words, autonomy means taking responsibility. So, taking responsibility. Next, coming to the fifth point, that is perception of reality. Perception of reality include the perception of the environment without distortion, as well as the capacity for empathy and social sensitivity, respect and concerns for the wants and the need of the others. So this is the perception of reality. Next, coming to the sixth point, that is environmental mastery. Environmental mastery means this indicator suggesting that the individual has achieved a satisfactory role within the group or society or any environment. So this is the environmental mastery. Means the individual playing role within any society or any environment or within the group. Next, coming to the characteristics. Characteristics means features. What are the features we will able to see within the mentally healthy person? So this is the characteristics. Here so many characteristics they have given. First one is the person has ability to make perception. Next, they have a sense of personal worth, feels worthwhile and important. Next, they solve their problems largely by making their own efforts and make their own decision. Next, they have sense of personal security and feel secure in a group and shows understanding of other people's problem and motives. Next, they have sense of responsibility. Next, the mentally healthy person can give and accept the love. Next, the last one is, they shows emotional maturity in his behavior and develops a capacity to tolerate frustration and disappointment in their daily life. So these all are the characteristics of mentally healthy person. Hope you have understand the topic. Thank you. We will meet at the next video.